I'm sure that you have probably heard of Prime, the drink from KSI and Logan Paul. Well, they are getting investigated by a U.S. food agency, or at least called on to be investigated for their Prime energy product, which has 200 milligrams of caffeine, or insane amounts compared to other things like Red Bull and Monster, especially if you compare it to Monster in a much bigger can, and it still has less caffeine. Which is kind of crazy for the brand that they're trying to make, saying Prime is the healthy version right there. Prime Hydration is supposed to be the healthy version of Gatorade, and Prime Energy, I guess, is supposed to be the healthier version of Red Bull and Monster, but they've gone the other way kind of and just pumped it full of caffeine and saying, look, it's an energy drink. You're supposed to get cracked off of it, even if that, I don't think that's really healthier, right? But Logan Paul has actually responded to some of these headlines and stuff, talking on Twitter. He posted a Twitter video about it. He's talking about prime example of bad media, where he's talking about these headlines for Prime, and he kind of skirts the whole main topic, the main topic being them being investigated by the government, the U.S. government. He doesn't really talk about it. He talks about some dumb headlines in Canada.
Perhaps you saw the news this morning. Complex, TMZ, Reuters, Forbes, and many more talking about how Prime Energy drinks were recalled in Canada. But the crazy part about that is we don't even distribute Prime Energy in Canada. Let me repeat that. We don't even distribute Prime Energy in Canada. So how could it be recalled? Well, the answer is illegal or unauthorized imports of the beverage. But
so we're starting here, starting off the video, talking about something that doesn't even matter. Right, talking about the bad media. The bad media is the titles that is being investigated by a U.S. food agency and the U.S. government. That's the big title. That's what you should talk about, right? Not that it's being recalled in Canada and how it's not your fault because you didn't even sell in Canada. Nothing's ever Logan's fault. It can't be. They don't even sell in Canada. What? Why this guy? These media's after Logan. So starting off strong, you know, the typical, this isn't my fault, we don't even do this, but let's see what else he's got to say.
But of course, traditional media doesn't care about that because they just want a headline, they want clicks. The level of misinformation currently being spread around Prime is actually insane. And you have to ask yourself why. Don't forget, we are a better for you product. Our energy drink has 10 calories and zero sugar. Prime formulas are compliant with each specific country's regulatory bodies. All of them. And yeah, our energy drink has caffeine in it. It's an energy drink.
That last part there, I think, is something that is kind of focused on, right, where you can say it's an energy drink and it has so much caffeine in it to make you so cracked throughout your day, and it has way more caffeine than Red Bull or Monster, and it's supposed to be healthier for you, but that doesn't sound very healthy for you. But the big problem that a lot of people have that are asking for this investigation is that they are marketing to kids. This thing that they say is an 18 plus product is marketed to kids. Like, their fan base is below 18, a lot of people, and a lot of their fans are going to go out and buy this. And if it's meant for 18 plus, but you're marketing to a lot of people under 18, that kind of doesn't make any sense. Now, there still has to be a level of personal responsibility, right? It's not all on Logan and KSI to make sure that you don't drink this if you're less than 18. Ultimately, that's your decision. But ignoring that you're marketing to a large portion of people under 18, knowing that you want this product to be 18 plus, is just kind of contradictory. It doesn't make a lot of sense. And also in the beginning of this clip, he talks about traditional media and they're just clickbaiting because they want clicks. But Logan, you know this, that you've been on YouTube for how long? Over a decade? You know clickbaiting is just what everybody does. Everyone on the internet clickbaits because everyone on the internet wants your click and they want your attention and they want money from you from ad revenue, so they're going to clickbait. It's nothing crazy and acting like, God, these guys will do anything for views. Like, yeah, we already know that. That's how everyone on the internet does that.
No, our low sugar, low calorie hydration drink doesn't have caffeine in it. But traditional news, and by the way, they're not even news anymore. It should be called stories because people are just making shit up to get clicks. They know that if they talk about Prime, whether the information they're spreading is true or not, they will get attention. On a product that is legitimately better for you, lower in sugar, lower in calories, and healthier ingredients than most of our competitors. So you know what? It actually doesn't surprise me that we're being targeted by massive corporate conglomerates and the United States government. Because using social media, we've affected effectively created a beverage so disruptive that it is eating the market share of some of the biggest corps on the planet.
I find this part kind of interesting because he's playing like both sides of the coin here, saying how Prime is an underdog and they're just trying to get up in the world and take on these big corporations. But then on the other hand, he's saying how, God, they're just eating so much market share and we're taking money out of their pockets. That's why they're so mad. That you can't have it both ways. That's not an underdog. If you're absolutely destroying and eating away market share, sure, I guess you can technically still be an underdog, but like you're not an underdog, right? You have a lot of market share. You got a good foothold in the market, insane marketing way to go about on social media. So you're an underdog, like technically, but you're also saying how you're destroying the markets and doing everything. It's like, come on, you got to pick one side or the other, right? And in the beginning, he talks about how it's so much healthier for you and stuff. But I think a channel called More Plates, More Dates did a video on this talking about like Prime hydration sticks, I think, and comparing them to Liquid IV, or he compared them to something, and talk about how the decisions they're making don't make much sense, doesn't make it healthier, doesn't do stuff. So you got to take, obviously, what Logan says with a grain of salt here, because obviously he's proven in the past that he doesn't have the best character. He kind of does anything for a little bit of money, even though he's already got tons of money.
And quite frankly, they're pissed. We're taking money out of their pocket. But honestly, I'm happy that people are seeing through the BS. I think the government and traditional media underestimates the collective intelligence of you, the American people. And although some people will be fooled, I am thankful that social media has given us, underdogs trying to make a business, a disruptive, better-for-you business, a voice to talk about the truth. Don't be fooled by the media. Take every headline with a grain of salt. And most importantly, drink Prime. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk.
So that's Logan Paul's response. Obviously, he's a little upset over the negative press from Prime after just saying he was a marketing genius for Prime, which is kind of weird for the Paul brothers to say anything about negative market, because they've always seemingly gone about this social media stuff as all publicity is good publicity. That's literally their entire strategy of how they got famous and made millions and millions of dollars on social media, is just doing anything and everything, getting attention, and not caring what that attention was for. But Logan, it seems like you are in love with Prime and want that business to grow and do so much great stuff, and you really care about it because you called yourself a marketing genius with it, first of all, and now you're defending it from these terrible headlines that Canada's recalling it. So obviously you care really, really a lot about Prime. So let's solve a big problem for you, because Logan, you have a problem. You scammed a bunch of people with CryptoZoo. You stole millions and millions of dollars. And it's time for you to get on the saddle and give everyone their money back. You should easily be able to afford this. You have tons of money. So sparing a few million on this CryptoZoo mistake shouldn't be a big problem. You don't even have to come out and say, I scammed everyone and we'll give your money back because we got caught by CoffeeZilla. Just come out and say, we're not doing this anymore. We're stopping the development. We're cutting it all. Not interested anymore. And we're going to give everyone their money back. Take the few million dollars, hit pay everyone their money back. You won't even notice the money leaving your account. And then you can finally bury this story and focus on what seems to be your golden business in Prime. Apparently, it's making you tens of millions of dollars, or Prime is doing tens of millions of dollars a month in revenue or profits. One of those two, probably revenue. But either way, it's churning money. It seemingly looks pretty successful. So bury the bad thing. Get rid of it. Stop just blocking people on Twitter because they talk about CryptoZoo. And focus on Prime. And move on from this whole thing. And then we can all do what CoffeeZilla said at the end of his video and go back to pretending like you've changed.